All right, Shalom. First and foremost, I'd like to give praises and glory and honor to Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shah, Bashem, Makakadash. Shalom to the elders, Wa'akim, Wa'akwaf, and I say Shalom. And the Heavenly Father, the true name is Yahweh, and His unbegotten Son, Bahashem, in the name Hamashiach, Avashah. Those are their true names in the ancient Paleo Hebrew, the Lashwan Kadash, the Holy Tongue. And I say Shalom to the elders, Wa'akim, Wa'akwaf, and I say Shalom. And this is a sit-down lesson that I want to get into the Joel, the third chapter.
Dance guy told your brother you say
this is the book of Joel, chapter 3 and verse 1. Salakia from momentarily pause. Salakia. Yup, this is the prophet Joel, chapter 3 and verse 1. It says, "For behold, in those days and in that time, I will bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem." Right, because Judah and Jerusalem are the Israelites, the children of Israel, because yet this day we stay in the land of our captivities, the actual Israelites. The sons and daughters of the true living power, which is Yahweh thy power, and we are the sons and daughters of the true living power, which is the actual Israelites, the biblical Israelites, of the respectable 12 tribes of Israel from the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom. Because scripture says, yet this day we still in the land of our captivities. So there's no new thing under the sun. Just like the ancient Israelites of our great forefathers and ancestors, they's in captivity in the ancient kingdoms. In the countries where they've been scattered at, and where we've been scattered at in these modern day times, you know, and throughout the whole world, because the book Hosea 1 and verse 10 said, Israel shall be as the sand of the sea. So, yet this day we still in the land of our captivities, the actual Israelites, you know, because the Heavenly Father, He's going to come back the second time to restore the remnant. He's going to come back for the remnant of His people. And I don't want to rock this out, Lord, with Him that we'd be part of that, you know. So we are definitely seeing that once again, so there's no new thing under the sun, you know. As that reference Ecclesiastes chapter 1 and verse 9. This is the prophet Joel chapter 3 and verse 1. It says, "For behold, in those days and in that time, I shall bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem." Joel chapter 3 and verse 2. And I will also gather all the nations and bring them down to the valley of Jehoshaphat, which is Yahweh Shabbat, the valley of decision, you know. So it's definitely heating up over there in the Red Sea, you know, because you had that recent report just came out that the, I believe it was, that was taking place over there in Western Asia. So the tensions are heating up over there. And then you had this recent news article that just came out, one that a high-ranking official, senior advisor, top commander got killed in an airstrike by the Israeli Defense Force. So, and you know, I just did a sit down lesson not too long ago. I said about like an hour ago, and you know, Iran said they was gonna vow revenge. You know, they're gonna do any means necessary, use a military action response, you know. So it's definitely heating up over there in the cross borders of Iraq, Syria, Lebanon, the Gaza Strip, the West Bank, the Palestinian territory, throughout Israel. So those escalations is only going to build up between Iran and Israel. So the tensions are only going to be up at a higher level between Iran and Israel, especially the increasing cross-border conflicts between the armies of nations. We received throughout over there in Western Asia. So it's only going to heat up over there in the area. And that's why we're seeing Joel, the third chapter, is in full effect right now as we're speaking, because this is a huge, major prophecy that we're seeing in progress. Joel, the third chapter, Ezekiel 38, chapter through verse 39, Isaiah 17, verse 1, you know. So that definitely that Isaiah 17 and verse 1 could be seeing Damascus is taken away from being a city, and it shall be as it will heat. The cross-border conflicts throughout Iraq and Syria, especially over there in Damascus, it's just heating up over there, especially the tensions between Syria and the IDF, which is the Israel Defense Force. You know, those Israelis, you know, they into it with the Syrian armies, right along with the Iranian back groups, you know, and the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps as well, too. And a top senior official commander got killed in an airstrike over there in Syria, you know, by the Israel Defense Force. So those escalations are only going to heat up, you know. Even though they've been in war with each other for a very long time, it's only going to increase, you know. So the Iranians ain't just gonna let that slip, you know. They not just gonna let that slide, you know. This is the prophet Joel, chapter 3 and verse 2. And I will gather all nations and bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat, which is Yahweh Shabbat, as I mentioned again, the valley of decision. So it's heating up over there in the valley of Jehoshaphat, Yahweh Shabbat, over there in Western Asia, because you got the Houthi rebels. You know, they recently just did a continued increasing of their airstrikes. So they're going to continue to target the coalition forces of Great Britain and the United States and the other nations that's allies with them as well, too, which is the Israel Defense Force, the United States and Great Britain, and other coalition forces as well, too. So it's only going to escalate over there in the Red Sea, you know, as both sides using airstrikes and drones against one another. And then you had the, I believe it's over there, the borders of, not too far from the Red Sea. You had a Iranian backed group. I believe they was in over there in Iraq. This claimed a drone strike assault over there on the Israelis, you know. So, you know, the Iranians and the Houthi rebels and the Palestinians, you know, they got a lot of allies. Just as much the Israel Defense Force do as well, too, because we already know the highly increasing of the allies between the United States and Israel, even though their relationship is kind of rocky between one another, you know. So, hey, we're going to see all out escalations throughout that whole region over there in the Red Sea, the Gulf of Eden, the Golden Heights, the Arabian Gulf over there in that area. And throughout the whole Western Asia, it's only going to continue this nonstop increasing escalations and wars and commotions between the armies of different nations that we are seeing over there in the area, you know. That's why Joel, the third chapter, is playing out right now as we speak, you know. Just like the prophets, you know, they're prophesying against great countries and great kingdoms of war, evil, and the pestilence, which is that's in Jeremiah 28, verse 8, you know. And that's what we're doing in modern day times. So we're going to continue to prophesy about great countries and great kingdoms of war, evil, and pestilence. Especially in the category of these wars. These wars is only going to increase, you know. And this is the prophet Joel, chapter 3 and verse 1. For behold, in those days and in that time, I will bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem. Verse 2. And I will gather all nations and bring them down to the valley of Jehoshaphat, which is Yahweh Shabbat. And I will plead with them for my people and for my heritage, Israel, right, us Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations, right? These nations have scattered the Israelites amongst the nations, because we was going to be scattered among all the nations. And yet to say we still in the land of our captivities. That's why we following these different cultures and different customs, different languages that don't actually belong to us. You know, these languages and customs belong to the other nations that we've been scattered amongst by. You know, so that's why scripture says, yet this day we still in the land of our captivities. You know, that's why the Heavenly Father is pleading with them for his people, for his heritage, Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations and part of his land. So you got the IDF, you got the small hatters, the 1948ers. You got those Ishmaelites, you know, all those three nations battling against one another. They basically just battling for a land that doesn't belong to them, even though Jerusalem is a people before us, a place, you know. This is Joel chapter 3 and verse 3. It says, "And they have cast lot for my people," right, the Israelites, "and they have given a boy for a harlot, and sold a girl for wine that they might drink," right, the transatlantic slave trade, the sub-Saharan slave trade, and this modern-day servitude that's taking place as well, too. That's why the scripture says in the book of Deuteronomy 28, verse 43, "The stranger that is within thee shall get above thee very high, and thou shalt come down very low." And that's what we are seeing in progress, but very soon it's going to flip. Because the Israelites, they're going to be the head, and these other nations are going to be the tail. They're going to serve the Israelites, because we are the actual Israelites, you know. Because very soon, that's going to turn. Because that's why we're seeing Deuteronomy 30 and verse 7 is in full effect as we speak. As the Heavenly Father continually, slowly but surely, gathering the nations up over there in the Valley of Jehoshaphat, which is Yahweh's power. You know? That's why we're seeing so much wars and escalations around the world. Because there's a controversy in Zion, the Zion, which is the actual Zion, which is the actual Zion, which is the Israelites, which is us, the actual real Zion, you know, the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the descendants of the sons and daughters of Jacob, the descendants of the Heavenly Father, true creator, which is Yahweh by power, the actual Israelites, from the ancient Israelites of our great forefathers and ancestors, you know, all the way into us, because we represent Jerusalem. Because the Israelites, they was an actual dark-skinned, complected people, and they still live to this day. You know, to the lighter brown, to the darker brown, because we different shades of brown, you know, because that shows you that we are the actual Israelites. You know, we fit these curses, we fit these scriptures that fits us, not those small hatters. Because it says in the book of Obadiah, "I will make thee small among the heathen that are great to despise, those Amalekites." So those three nations battling over a land that doesn't belong to them. That's why the Heavenly Father slowly but surely gathered the nations up over there, you know, for his heritage, for his people, you know, who they scattered among the nations and part of his land. They still the part of the Lord's land. They divided his land. They defiled his land, and they messing up his land, and they battling over a land that doesn't belong to them. That's why the Heavenly Father is slowly but surely gathering them up over there for them to jack each other up, and the Heavenly Father jack them up as well, too. That's how beautiful how the Heavenly Father got all this set up and putting them in that ultimate in that trick bag, you know. This is Joel chapter 3 and verse 3. "And they have cast lot for my people," right, the Israelites, Judah, and Jerusalem. "And they have given a boy for a harlot, and sold a girl for wine that they might drink." Right, because the Heavenly Father have forgot about you Ishmaelites, you know. Because I believe it's Genesis, the 16th chapter, explains Ishmael should be as a wild man, you know. And he's a wild man towards everybody. But the Heavenly Father ultimately haven't forgot about you Ishmaelites, what you did to the children of Israel still to this day. Making money in their community, you know, exploiting them, using them as servitude, just like you did the diaspora of the southern kingdom of Judah, Benjamin, and Levi, and still to this day. That's why last year over there in Libya, you know, when they was doing a little servitude and slavery was taking place throughout Libya, and they got hit with a big old earthquake and a flooding over there, you know. So that's the recompense the Heavenly Father is doing to us, those Ishmaelites. So the Heavenly Father, is, even though the Heavenly Father is slow to anger, but he haven't forgot about you Ishmaelites, you know, because Arabs is a mixed multitude, you know, because a lot of them mix with the offspring of Edomites, you know, Greek Edomite babies. But you know, those Ishmaelites, the Heavenly Father have forgot about them as well, too. And it definitely explains it in Joel, the 3rd chapter, you know. Just like it says in Psalms, the 83rd chapter, verse 1 through verse 7, "These nations have confederate against the children of Israel still to this day." Even though we jacking each other up, you know, but the Heavenly Father ultimately haven't forgot about what these nations did to his people. That's why we see in Joel, the 3rd chapter is playing out. It's in fully increasing progress as we speak. And that's why we're out here prophesying about wars, evils, and the pestilence, just like the prophets of old did. That's what we're seeing in these modern day times. So there's no new thing under the sun. So those Ishmaelites, the Heavenly Father haven't forgot about them, what they did to his people, and still to this day. That's why that ultimate recompense is increasing. We've seen it more and more and more. And it's going to be a full recompense of those Ishmaelites, those Amalekites, those Edomites, all the nations. It's like it says in Obadiah 1 verse 15, you know. This is Joel chapter 3 and verse 4. It says, "Yea, what have ye to do with me, O Tyre and Zidon, which those Hamitic nations, and all the coast of Palestine, those Ishmaelites?" I was just got through talking about them just a minute ago. It says, "Will you render me a recompense?" Question mark. And if you recompense me swiftly and speedily, and I will turn your recompense upon your own head. Right, so that Father is definitely going to turn that recompense upon their own head times double. This is the prophet Joel, chapter 3, verse 5. "Because you have taken my silver and my gold, my goodly." It says, "Because you have taken my silver and my gold and carried them into your temple, my goodly present things." Right? Because we are the apple of the Lord's eye. We are his chosen people, the sons and daughters of the true living power of him. Joel, chapter 3, verse 6. It says, "The children also of Judah and the children of Jerusalem." Right, Judah and Jerusalem, the 12 tribes of Israel, "have ye sold unto the Grecians?" Right, because during those ancient times, the ancient Grecians was a dark-skinned, complected people, was the Japhetic people, due to the colonizations and taking over. Because, you know, you got these modern-day Grecians with these Edomites, you know. This is, so their recompense is definitely coming upon these Grecian Edomites and all the whole Idumea, Ishashua, he that wastes away, the Idumeans, you know. That's why we're prophesying against a modern day Mount Seir, you know, which is over there in Petra of Jordan, you know, ancient Mount Seir. Now we're prophesying against a modern day Mount Seir, you know. So there's no new thing under the sun. This is Joel chapter 3 and verse 6. It says, "The children also of Judah and the children of Jerusalem have ye sold unto the Grecians," right, the Edomites, "that you might remove them far from their border," right, from our ancestors and forefathers all the way down to us in these modern day times. We've been removed far from our border and still to this day due to the colonizations and the captivities, you know, and these nations have been scattering us. And we've been barred from our homeland. We've been removed from our homeland, from our borders, you know, because we've been scattered among all the nations. What are these nations that have led us into captivity? From our ancestors and forefathers all the way down to us in these modern day times. That's why the scripture says, "Yet this land is still in the land of our captivities," you know. But we was gonna remember ourselves in the lands where we've been scattered at, you know. This is Joel chapter 3 verse 7. It says, "Behold, I will raise them up out of the place where you have sold them." Right, so the Heavenly Father will raise us up out of the place where you have sold them. That's what you're seeing, this true awakening of the Israelites is waking up to who the fact they actually are in these latter days, you know, in the signs of the times. Because these are the modern day signs of the times, of these biblical times. And these increasing biblical signs, you're going to see more and more and more. And you're going to see these prophecies that's about to be fulfilled and come to pass as well, too. In Joel, the third chapter, is one of them. Armageddon, World War III. Armageddon, one, you know, World War III. Second will pass, behold, third will come quickly, you know. And this is what we are prophesying about, you know. We seeing it in progress as we're speaking. But I'm going to continue on. Let me charge up my phone a little bit more. I think it's on 10%, so it's locked in. You know how these phones is, they die real quick. Charge it up. So I'm going to continue on with the reading. And this is the prophet Joel, chapter 3, verse 9. That might not be the worst of it. I'm going to start at verse 7 again. This is of the prophet Joel, chapter 3, verse 7. It says, Behold, I will raise them up at a place where you have sold them, and I will return your recompense upon your own head. Right, so that recompense is definitely coming upon these own head, these other nations, what they did to the children of Israel, you know. As I've mentioned, reference Obadiah 1, verse 15 explains that. This is Joel chapter 3 and verse 8. It says, "Now I will sell your sons and your daughters into the hands of the children of Judah." Right, just like their ancestors and forefathers were selling our ancestors and forefathers. And now in these modern day times as well too. You know, because Heavenly Father, he sees that. Hey, he haven't forgot about what these nations did to his people and still to this day. Because the stranger that's within thee shall get above thee very high, and thou shalt come down very low. But very soon, we're going to be the head, and they're going to be the tail. But right now, they are the tail, we are the head. I mean, right now, they are the head, we the tail. But very soon, it's going to do a quick 360. It's going to be a flip around, you know. And that's what we're seeing, that's in progress, as we're speaking, you know. This is Joel chapter 3, verse 8. And I will sell your sons and your... It says, "And I will sell your sons and your daughters into the hands of the children of Judah. And they shall sell them to the Sabarians, to the people far off." I believe the Sabarians are those people in modern-day Yemen. It says, "To a people far off, from the Lord Yahweh thy power has spoken." Right, for the Lord Yahweh thy power has spoken out of his own mouth, you know. Hey, so what goes around comes around, you know. And they're going to get it times double what they did to the children of Israel. So they made a huge mistake what they did to the children of Israel, you know. This is the prophet Joel, chapter 3, verse 9. It says, "Proclaim ye this amongst the Gentiles, prepare war, wake up the mighty men. Let all the men of war draw near and let them come up." Right, and that's what we're seeing around the world. Because you just recently had this military joint exercise drills. Because it's going to be a bilateral summit, I believe, like in April the 11th, if I'm not mistaken, from the Philippines, Japan, and the United States. Because they was going to start in April 11th, I think they was going to do the bilateral joint patrol drills over there in the South China Sea, if I'm not mistaken. Because the ongoing tensions are heating up between China and the Philippines, and not too far from the South China Sea, you know, the territorial islands, you know, because tensions been heating up and been sparking up for the past couple of months, previously and as of recently as well too, against China and the Philippines over there in the territorial islands, you know, because you have China bullying these nations over there in the territorial islands, trying to claim the island over there for themselves. And you got those other Eastern Asian countries over there trying to claim other islands as well too. But China being the big bully up there, that's why you're seeing escalations heating up that as well too. And when we see what's taking place over there in the South China Sea, you know, China versus Taiwan. Because you still got that one China policy. Because you know China still look at Taiwan as one of them, even though they separated from China ever since 1949. And they look at that as a self-sovereign island over there in the Taiwan Islands, you know, in the Taiwan Strait and the Taiwan Islands. As you see, China continue to building up their military presence over there in that area. So it's only going to, those escalations are only going to increase between China versus Taiwan. And the United States going to have to intervene in that as well too. As they've been monitoring the situation. The United States Army been monitoring China's every situation. And Taiwan been monitoring China's military moves over there, being built up over there in the South China Sea as they're getting closer and closer to invading Taiwan. Because, you know, China still want Taiwan to be one of them because they still have that one China policy. So they're going to do any means necessary to force them to be back with them, you know. And that's when the United States is going to have to interfere with them because you have this increasing unofficial allies with, you know, with China and Taiwan. Because, you know, recently the United States deployed some troops over there to train Taiwanese soldiers. They funded them all that money, you know. They funded them the military equipment over there as well, too, to train them. while you have in China is building up their military presence over there as they're getting closer and closer to invading Taiwan. Because you had the President Xi Jinping from previous years of last year, and as of recently, been saying it countless of times over and over and over again, telling the Chinese army is getting prepared for war, prepare for war, prepare for war, prepare for invasion of Taiwan, you know? So it's heating up over there. What we're seeing with the Russian-Ukraine situation, that's only going to intensify. EU versus NATO, Russia versus NATO, Belarus and Russia, former USSR Soviet members. Ever since 1994, they have divided, you know, against one another. We're seeing Russia versus NATO, EU versus NATO. So all these tensions are only going to increase. Not just only the Russian-Ukraine situation, outside of the Russian-Ukraine situation, got other nations being part of that as well too. So it's only going to escalate tensions more and more war. So keep in mind, as of last month, you had NATO, their biggest military exercise drill ever since Cold War. So they sending that message to Russia, you know. Even though Vladimir Putin keep on denying the fact that he has no ill intention to go to war or have any intentions or animosity, hostility towards NATO, even though he's been sending warnings, even though he's been sending his military equipment not too far from the borders of the NATO allies, you know, like Sweden and Finland, because you had Sweden and Finland recently just made the official announcement, just joining NATO. I believe it was February or March they made that announcement. So they want to build up their military presence, you know. So it's only going to increase over there. Meanwhile, you have Russia recently deported their troops over there to Belarus. They recently deported their military equipment over there as well, too. And Belarus been testing it now. So that shows you the escalations are only going to increase, you know, these Edomite nations have towards one another. No, so we're going to see the great divisions between the Edomite nations, you know, and that's what we're seeing. So all this is playing out in Joel, the third chapter. You know, the second will pass, behold, the third will come quickly. So all those tensions that's taking place throughout that whole region over there, Western Asia, is only going to increase. So all these wars and escalations that we're seeing in the world today is only going to increase, you know, it's going to manifest more and more and more. And these are the times, are the signs of the times that we're living in. And that's why we're prophesying about war, evil, and the pestilence, especially the categories of wars. These wars is only going to increase. Just like the scripture says, and ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. And that's what we're hearing, increasing and manifesting more and more and more of these increasing wars and rumors of wars. But these wars and rumors of wars are starting to become actual wars between the armies of nations. Because nations has nothing against another nation of armies, you know, and that's what we're seeing. It's only going to increase, you know. And this is the prophet Joel, chapter 3 and verse 9. Proclaim ye this amongst the Gentiles, prepare war, right? So the Heavenly Father putting that warlike mindset of these armies of nations, and that's what we're seeing, you know, because Exodus 15:3, the Lord Yahweh thy power, he's a man of war himself as well, too. So he orchestrated this, you know, he's setting all this up. And Heavenly Father, he's the ultimate chess player. He's the ultimate chess player champion. Hey, Yahweh, thy power, the true creator. You know, he's setting all this up, and that's what we're seeing that's taking place throughout the whole world. Escalations and tensions between the armies of different nations. And so it's only going to increase, and it's not going to slow down. If it do, it might slow down a little bit, but the tensions are only going to escalate right back up. Because the scripture says, for one nation will say peace and safety, and sudden destruction come upon them, you know. Because the Heavenly Father, he's a righteous, balanced power. Sometimes he might keep a little peace and let it down, cool it down, but he's going to amp it right back up. And that's what the Heavenly Father does, because he's in control of everything, you know. This is the prophet Joel, chapter 3, verse 9. I'm going to read it again. It says, proclaim ye this amongst the Gentiles. It says, prepare war. Wake up the mighty man, right? Heavenly Father waking up the mighty man of the armies of these nations. That's what we are seeing. I believe North Korea recently just fired off their intermediate ballistic missiles, according to a report from South Korea. Yeah, I believe it's, South Korea or Japan. They have fired once again their missile over there in the eastern shores of Japan. While you have in the rising tensions are heating up over the Korean Peninsula between North Korea, South Korea, Japan, and the United States. So those tensions are only going to escalate because Kim Jong-un been building up his military capability as he been visiting the military quarters over there in that area to build up his army and telling them to get prepared to fully train for them to get ready to prepare for war with South Korea. You know, especially North Korea and South Korea just made more division between each other, you know, ever since they separated and withdrawn from that 2018 PAC deal, I believe, military PAC deal. So that's just only going to make them divided more with one another. And then you got the coalition forces of the South Korea, Japan, and the United States going against North Korea. Because North Korea, they recently seen that that military exercise drill between, I would say, Japan, South Korea, and the United States, especially between Japan and the United States and North Korea, look at that as a provocation of an invasion of for actual war that they're going to have with the United States and South Korea and Japan. So, hey, that's why we're seeing Joel, the third chapter is in progress as we speak, you know. And this is the prophet Joel, chapter 3, verse 9. Proclaim ye this amongst the Gentiles, prepare war. Wake up the mighty man. Let all the men of war draw near. Let them come up. Right, the Auschwitz and Armenian situation, even though it had cooled down a little bit, it's only going to escalate once again. I won't be surprised if it sparks once again. And as of last month, I remember I did a lesson on it. It was saying from the representations from either Armenian or Azerbaijan, if I'm not mistaken, saying that he was warning the leaders if they don't get like sovereignty back from either Azerbaijan or Armenia, if I'm not mistaken. I'm not trying to make it like miscalculate that, you know. But he was saying that it might be a potential all-out war with them, even though they've been having an all-out war with each other for a very long time. But those escalations, we're seeing signs of it, is only going to increase. Because we've been having little proxy wars back and forth, you know, soldiers shooting at other soldiers across the borders of Azerbaijan, Armenia situation. And then you've been having the Russian peacekeeper trying to keep the peace. But, hey, they've been going on and off. They've been trying to hold it, but it's been, you know, unbalanced and unstable, and the escalation's been heating up. You know, even they have a little small wars here and there, but we definitely gonna see the increasing sparks of it, you know. And that's what we see in Joel, the third chapter. Definitely Joel 3 and verse 9 of the nations gonna continue to be up in that warlike mindset as the Heavenly Father gonna continue to increasingly more and more and more put the warlike mindset of these armies of nations. And that's what we're seeing, you know. It says Joel chapter 3 verse 10. It says, beat your plowshares and the swords and the pulling hooks and the spears and let the weak say I'm strong. Right, that's what we're seeing. Make sure everything alright. Yep, so beat your plowshares and the swords and the pulling hooks and let the weak say I'm strong. And that's what we're seeing, let the weak say I'm strong. So we're definitely gonna continue to see North Korea launching their missiles, upgrading their nuclear capability. As I mentioned again, when I was out there teaching earlier yesterday, because you know today is 1:42, and I was mentioned when I was out there teaching earlier yesterday, you had India, they just fired one of their upgradable missiles for, I would say, for like the second, third time already. And then they recently just purchased a upgradable hypersonic missile. So we seeing the nations, so this is just significant signs that I've been indicating and mentioning of these nations are building up their nuclear capability. That's why we've been seeing military finance of all the nations that have been funding their money in their military. It's been up at an all-time high ever since World War II. So that shows you what mindset of these armies they're entering into, you know. So that Joel chapter 3 verse 9 makes perfect sense. Joel 3 verse 10 makes perfect sense. And we're definitely living in those times. So we're going to continue to see the increasing military exercise between the nations and against their adversaries. And that's what we're seeing right now. So we're going to see military exercise drills at an all-time high. It's only going to increase more and more and more, you know. A military spending, it's on an all-time high, like I mentioned again, ever since World War II. And then you're going to have wars and escalations, wars and commotions. that we're seeing at an all-time high that's going to increase and that's going to skyrocket. And these are the times that we're entering into, you know. So we're definitely going to continue to see Iran building up their nuclear capability. And these armies of nations that you wouldn't expect a very long time ago would have had the financial connections, the military connections, the military ways to upgrade their nuclear capabilities, more upgradable missiles, even if it's from a short range, long range, immediate range, you know, the increasing, creating more nuclear bombs, more the enrichments, which Iran been doing for quite a while. As a report came out not too long ago, I say like a couple of months ago, you had the UN watchdog was watching the report of they was kind of worried about if Iran building up their nuclear capability, because they've been reaching from 30% to 35% to 50%, 60%, 75% to 80% to 85%, now to 90% of an increasing more stockpile of nuclear weapons, of hypersonic ballistic upgradable missiles, and increasing to be able to create more nuclear bombs to their already nuclear arsenal, what they already actually have, you know. Just like Russia recently just launched a missile test, you know, which they recently did not about a couple of months ago. They just launched the Satan-2 missile, sending that warning to the West and the United States. So that shows you that the escalations are only going to heat up between these armies of different nations and different kingdoms rising up against one another. So you're going to have one armies of nations rising up against one another, and you're going to have allies of armies rising up against one another. So that's why I've been mentioning about, even though we've been having escalations between Iran and Israel be heating up, hey, you've been having, you know, Israel and the United States armies been bickering towards one another. And that's what we're going to be seeing as well, too. So you're going to have great division between the armies and the allies against one another while they're trying to focus in on their adversaries, but they're going to have division between one another as well, too. We're going to see that as well, too, you know. But we're definitely seeing that Joel, the third chapter, is in full effect. These armies of nations are rising up against one another, and it's only going to increase. So what's taking place over there in the Valley of Jehoshaphat, which is Yahweh Shabbat, it's only going to increase, you know. So clashes and escalations between the Houthi rebels, which is an Iranian-backed group, they're going to continue to target anybody that's affiliated with the United States and the coalition forces from Great Britain and the United States and the IDF and other coalition forces that teamed up with the United States about 2 months ago. So those tensions are only going to escalate between both sides, because you're going to use the Great Britain of their armies and the United States of their armies and the IDF of their armies. They're going to continue to use airstrikes, you know, throughout the Red Sea, you know, throughout Damascus, throughout Syria, you know, throughout Iraq, throughout Lebanon, the Gaza Strip, the Palestinian territory, throughout Israel, throughout Ashdod, throughout the whole region. It's going to be back and forth collisions between the armies of nations. They're going to rise up against one another even more and more and more, especially with the latest escalations be heating up between Iran and Israel, which is the IDF, which is only going to increase between both sides. They're going to have increasing higher hostility towards one another, animosity towards one another. So they're going to look at each other as the ultimate arch nemesis between, you know, Israel, which is the IDF, Israel Defense Force, going against the pro-Iranian groups, the Syrian armies, and the coalition forces. That's where we're starting to see the rise of the Dragons of Arabia teaming up against the United States, you know, against the IDF and the other coalition forces as well, too, you know, that fully support these IDFs. So you're going to have the Syrian armies, Russia, Turkey, even though Turkey played both ends of the fence. But we're going to see all, that's why Ezekiel 38th chapter is full of importance as well, too. We're seeing that in progress, as I referenced that a while, about 20 minutes ago. You know, Ezekiel 38th chapter is in full effect, the verse 39. Isaiah 17 and verse 1, Jeremiah 51 and verse 46, Revelations 9 and verse 12, Revelations 11 and verse 14, you see that as well too, you know. only going to increase, you know, and it's going to intensify as we see it more and more and more, you know. And this is what we're out here prophesying about war, evil, and the pestilence, as I referenced Jeremiah 28 and verse 8. Because the prophets of old, you know, they prophesied against great countries and great kingdoms of war, evil, and the pestilence. And that's what we're doing right now in these modern day times as we're speaking. You know, prophesying against great countries and great kingdoms of war, evil, and the pestilence. So these wars is only going to continue to increase, and it's only going to intensify. And it's not going to let up, and it's not going to slow down, you know. It's only going to increase, and it's only going to heat up by the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, by power. The prophet Joel, chapter 3, verse 9, it says, "Proclaim ye this amongst the Gentiles, prepare war. Wake up the mighty man. Let all the men of war draw near, and let them come up." The prophet Joel, chapter 3, verse 10, "Beat your plowshares and swords and the plenty hooks into spears, and let the weak say, I'm strong." Right, so we're going to continue, let the seed, the weak say, I'm strong. Beat your plowshares and swords and the plenty hooks into spears, and let the weak say, I'm strong. So these are nations that you would consider not as a good, solid armies, but we're starting to see, let the weak say, I'm strong. So it's only going to increase. So these nations going against their adversaries, they're going to continue building up their nuclear capability, and they're going to continue to finance their nuclear capability, and they're going to continue to fully train and be in that warlike mindset and continue to prepare for war against their adversaries, and that's what we're seeing. So what's taking place over there in the Red Sea, it's only going to escalate, it's only going to heat up, you know. Joel chapter 3 verse 11, "Assemble yourselves and come, all you heathen," which is the armies of the other nations. It says, "And cause thy mighty ones to come down, O Lord Yahweh, thy power." Joel chapter 3 and verse 12, "Let the heathen be wakened and come up into the valley of Jehoshaphat," which is Yahweh Shapath, Yahweh's decision, the Heavenly Father's decision over there in Western Asia. It says, "For there I will sit and judge all the heathen round about." Right, so the Heavenly Father is going to sit and judge all the heathen round about. That's why he's continually, increasingly, and slowly to gather the nations over there in the Valley of Jehoshaphat, you know. This is Prophet Joel, chapter 3, verse 13. "Put ye in the sickle, for the harvest is ripe. Come ye eat down, for the press is full, and the fats overflow, for that wickedness is great." Joel chapter 3 verse 14, it says, "Multitudes and multitudes in the valley of decision, for the day of the Lord Yahweh thy power is near in the valley of decision." Right, so the day of the Lord Yahweh thy power is getting close and very near into the valley of decision, you know. Now I'm going to bring out Ezekiel. Yeah, this is Ezekiel, the 38th chapter. Yep, this is the prophet Ezekiel, chapter 38. Yep, this is the prophet Ezekiel, chapter 38, verse 1, since I referenced this scripture. It says, "And the word of the Lord came unto me, saying," the word of the Lord, which is the Heavenly Father, Yahweh thy power. It says, "And the word of the Lord, Yahweh thy power, came unto me, saying," verse 2, "Son of man," which is we are the Israelites, the sons of the true living power, "because the Heavenly Father has set us as to be watchmen of the house of Israel, sounding a long blowing trumpet," which is Joel 2 and verse 1, in Ezekiel the 3rd chapter. It says, "Son of man, set thy face against God," which represents the Russia, the bear of Gog and land of Magog, the chief prince of Meshach and Tubal, and the land of Magog and the chief prince of Meshach and Tubal, and prophesy against them. Right, and that's what we're doing, prophesying against Gog and land of Magog and the chief prince of Meshach and Tubal. Ezekiel, just like the ancient prophets of old did, our great forefathers, now you see that in modern day times, because there's no new thing in the sun, Ecclesiastes 1 and verse 9. Verse 3, Ezekiel 38, verse 3, "And thus saith the Lord Yahweh thy power, behold, I am against thee, O Gog, and the chief prince of Meshach and Tubal." Right, chief prince of Meshach and Tubal, which represents Gog and land of Magog, you know, the bear, which is the Russians. You know. Ezekiel 38, verse 4, it says, "And I will turn thee back and put hooks into thy jaws, and I will bring thee forth from all thy armies. And horse and horsemen, all of them clothed with all sorts of armor, even a great company of bucklers and shields, and all of them handling swords. Right, so the Heavenly Father is increasingly now so more than ever in these modern day times putting that warlike mindset into these Russians, which represents Gog and Magog and the chief priests and Meshach and Tubal, you know. Putting them back in that USSR type spirit, you know. So putting them in that fully warlike mindset, you know. This is Ezekiel chapter 38 verse 5. It says Persia, which is Iran, Elam, Ethiopia, the Cushites, and Libya, with all of them with shield of Hammond, right, with all of them fully equipped with armor, shield of Hammond. You know, Ethiopia, the Cushites, Libya, the Ishmaelites, and Iran, which is Elam. Ezekiel 38 and verse 6, Gomer, which is the modern day Turks. That's why the tensions are heating up. The cross border conflicts between the Turkish armies and the Kurdistan armies throughout Iraq and Syria, even though I've been mentioning it numerous of times. Because Gomer represents the Turks. This is Ezekiel chapter 38, verse 6. It says, Gomer and all his bands, the house of Togomor of the north quarters, and all his bands, and many people with thee. The prophet Ezekiel 38, verse 7. It says, be thou prepared and prepare for thyself and all thy companies that are assembled unto thee. Be thou a guard unto them. Right, so Russia is definitely going to be a guard to these nations. Iran, Ethiopia, Libya, and Turkey. That's why it's definitely heating up over there in Iraq and Syria. As you had Russia just recently reinforced. It was about 2 months ago, 2.5 months ago. As it's entering in its third month now. Reinforcements being redeployed it over there with the Russian and Syrian army, because you know they dealing with forces over there in the area as well too, and at the same time dealing with the IDF. So that's why Russia is definitely going to be a guard to these nations of Iran, Ethiopia, Libya, and Turkey, especially over there in Western Asia, while at the same time Russia is dealing with the Russian-Ukraine situation and outside of Russia-Ukraine as well too, you know. So we definitely seeing that Ezekiel 38 chapter is playing out. So Russia is going to be a guard to these nations of Iran, Ethiopia, Libya, and Turkey. And as I mentioned this a couple of days ago, and I've mentioned this as recently as well too, over there in the land of Kush, the Kushites, they recently had the Russian ship been deployed over there in that area of the land of Kush. Recently, as of last year, I believe in South Africa, they recently just had a military extraterrestrial with Russia and South Africa. That been took place as well too, because they had a summit took place last July, I believe. So the coalition forces are increasing between, you know, the Kushites and Russia, which represents the bear of Gog and Magog and the chief prince of Meshach and Tubal. So that's why Russia is going to be a guard to these nations over there in Africa in the land of Ham and Kush, you know. So they're going to team up with them. So Russia is definitely going to be a guard into them of Iran, Ethiopia, Libya, and Turkey. Now in Turkey, they playing both sides of the fence, you know, but Turkey is definitely still going to be on the side of Russia. Because, you know, not too long ago, you had the president of Turkey for accusing the IDF for war crimes. Just like a couple of days ago, you had Russia blame the IDF, which is the Israel Defense Force, for using airstrikes constantly, consistently over there in Damascus and throughout Syria, killing innocent men, women, and children, and army men over there in Syria. Because, you know, you got President Bashar and Russia, Vladimir Putin, which is increasing allies with one another ever since 2015, you know. So we're definitely seeing Ezekiel 38 chapter is definitely playing out, you know. So continuing on, this is Prophet Ezekiel chapter 38 verse 7, read again. It says, be thou prepared and prepare for thyself and all thy companies that are assembled unto thee, be thou a guard unto them. So Russia is definitely continuously is going to be a guard to these nations of Iran, Ethiopia, Libya, and Turkey, throughout Western Asia and throughout the Russia-Ukraine situation as well too. So the NATO versus Russia, that's only going to heat up. The Russia-Ukraine situation is only going to heat up. And Russia doing a lot of military activity, being a guard unto these nations of Iran, Ethiopia, Libya, and Turkey. Over there in the land of Ham and Kush, and over there in Western Asia as well, too, it's only only going to increase. That's why we're seeing Ezekiel 38 chapters in full effect, because this is a major prophecy that's about to be fulfilled, you know. So we're living in those times. It's in progress as we're speaking, you know. And this is what we're prophesying about: war, evil, and oppression, especially the categories of wars, as I mentioned again, consistently, you know. This is Prophet Ezekiel 39. Yeah, the Prophet Ezekiel 39 and verse 1. It says, "Therefore, thou son of man, prophesy against God." Right, that's what we're doing. It's like the prophets of old did. Now we're doing this in modern day times. This is the Prophet Ezekiel 39 and verse 1. I'm going to read it again for edification's sake of the sit down lesson. It says, "Therefore, thou son of man, prophesy against God and say, thus saith the Lord Yahweh thy power, behold, I am against thee, O Gog and the chief prince of Meshach and Tubal." Verse 2, "And I will turn thee back and leave but the sixth part of thee, and I will cause them to come up from the north parts, and I will bring thee upon the mountains of Israel." Verse 3, "And I will smite thy bow out of thy left hand, and I will cause thy arrows to fall out of thy right hand." Come. And this is the prophet Isaiah. Yeah, this is the prophet Isaiah. Yep, this is Prophet Isaiah. Yep, this is the Prophet Salakia for that. This is Prophet Isaiah 17 and verse 1. "The burden of Damascus. Behold, Damascus is taken away from being a city, and it shall be as a ruined heap." Right, so Damascus is taken away from being a city, and it shall be as a ruined heap, and that's what we are seeing. You know, the cross-border conflict between Iran and Israel is heating up. And, you know, the coalition forces with Hezbollah, Syrian armies, and Iran and the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps as well, too. Just like I mentioned again, about 15 to 20 minutes ago, you had the top Iranian senior commander of Iran. You know, it was, I believe it was two of them, got two generals of the Iranian Revolutionary Guard Corps got killed in an airstrike over there in Syria once again. And the one not so long ago, I would say about a month and a half ago, over there in Lebanon as well too. So the borders of us between Syria and Lebanon is heating up, you know, especially over there in Damascus. So we're gonna continue to see Damascus is taken away from being a city, and it shall be as a warm heap. And we're seeing that in progress as we're speaking, you know. Isaiah 17 and verse 1, "The burden of Damascus. Behold, Damascus is taken away from being a city, and it shall be as a ruined heap." Because you got military armies of facilities that the IDF keep on continuing to target from the borders of Israel and throughout, from, I would say, from Israel through Syria, which is over in Damascus. But it's heating up throughout the whole region of Syria as well, too, but mostly primarily over there in Damascus. So the tensions between Iran versus Israel is only going to heat up, you know, between both sides, you know. And this is Jeremiah. Yep, this is Prophet Jeremiah 51 and verse 46. It says, "Unleash your heart faith, and ye shall fear for the rumor that shall be heard in the land. A rumor shall be both come 1 year, and after that, another year, and shall come a rumor and violence in the land, ruler against ruler. Right, just like that was taking place in ancient times, during Jeremiah's time, during the prophets' times, because they was prophesying against great countries and great kingdoms of war, evil, and pestilence. And that's taking place right now as we're speaking these modern-day times, you know, Jeremiah 51 and verse 46. You can definitely relate that to modern-day times as well, too, you know. So it's heating up over there in Western Asia. Bring out the book of Habakkuk. So, hey, this is a vision. The vision is yet for the point of time, and at the end of shall speak, and that's what we're seeing with these increasing biblical signs of war, evil, and the pestilence. Matter of fact, before I bring that up, bring out Jeremiah, the prophet Jeremiah 28, verse 8. As I've been mentioning that scripture numerous of times, so Salakia. Yeah, this is the prophet Jeremiah, chapter 28, verse 8. It says, the prophets that have been before thee and before thee of old, both prophesied against many countries and great kingdoms of war, even the pestilence. Right, during our great forefathers, you know, during his time and the prophets' times, you know, they was prophesying against great countries and great kingdoms of war, evil, and the pestilence. And that's what we're doing in modern-day times, you know, prophesying against great countries and great kingdoms of war, evil, and the pestilence. Especially the categories of a war, so the wars is only going to increase, you know. Now I'm going to bring out Habakkuk. This is the book of Habakkuk. It's Nahum. I'm trying to get to Habakkuk. Yep, this is the prophet Habakkuk, chapter 2, verse 1. And I will stand upon my watch and set upon the tower and watch to see what I will say unto me and what I shall answer when I am approved. Habakkuk 2 and verse 2. And the Lord Yahweh thy power answer and say, write the vision and make it plain upon the tables, that he may run that readeth forth right. Scripture says, blessed he that readeth forth. And Habakkuk 2 and verse 3, for the vision is yet from the point of time, but at the end it shall speak, and not lie thou and tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, and it will not tarry. Right, so the signs, you know, we seeing them, in the increase in biblical signs, and these prophecies that's about to be fulfilled. They said, thou tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. So the vision is yet from the point in time, and at the end it shall speak, thou tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come. You know, as I was in read in Habakkuk 2 and verse 1 through verse 3, you know. Hey, so the vision is yet for a point in time, it's there. And at the end it shall speak, thou tarry, wait for it, because it will surely come, you know. This is the prophet Daniel's. Yep. This is prophet Daniel's 12 verse 1. It says, and at that time shall Michael stand up, the great prince, which standeth for the children of my people, which is the Israelites, which he did in ancient times, and we're going to see that in modern day times. And it shall be a time of trouble, and never this will since a nation, even to the same time, and at that time thy people shall be delivered, and everyone shall be found written in the book. Daniel 12 and verse 2, and many of them that sleep in the dust of the earth shall awake, some to everlasting life, some to shame and everlasting contempt. Daniel 12 and verse 3, and it reads, it says, and they that shall be wise shall shine as the brightness of the firmament, and they that turn many to the righteousness as the stars forever and ever. Daniel 12 and verse 4, for that whole thing shall with the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end, many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall increase. Right, so many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall increase. And I'm going to get into that, Ezekiel 33 and verse 33. So yeah, the vision is yet from the point of time, but at the end it shall speak. And that's what we are seeing. Get to that prophet Ezekiel, Salakia. So like I mentioned again, this is what we're prophesying about war, evil, and the pestilence. As I was getting to the main topic of the chapter, the main topic of the sit-down lesson, you know, Joel, the third chapter. And I used some precepts to help me along the way. Bring out Ezekiel 33 and verse 33. Matter of fact, get to that Ecclesiasticus, the third chapter. Yep, this is Ecclesiasticus chapter 3 and verse 1. It says, to everything there is a season and a time of every purpose under heaven. Right, for there is a time, to seasons, and every purpose under heaven, you know. Verse 2. In a time to be born, in a time to die, in a time to plant, in a time to pluck up that which is planted. Ecclesiasticus chapter 3 and verse 3, in a time to kill, in a time to heal, in a time to break down, in a time to build up. Verse 4, in a time to weep, in a time to laugh, in a time to mourn, in a time to dance, right? Because everything is in the hands of the power, the living power, which is the heavenly Father, Yahweh, thy power, because he's a righteous, balanced power. You know, Ecclesiastes 12, verse 14, whether it be a secret, whether it be good, or whether it be evil, because he's in control of everything. A righteous, balanced power, a righteous, balanced judge power, which is the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, thy power. But we are definitely are living in the modern days of times and seasons and every purpose of heaven, especially these increasing biblical signs we're seeing in the world today, and these increasing prophecy that's about to be fulfilled. So we are definitely living in those modern day times and seasons and every purpose of heaven. So there's a new thing on the sun. This is Ecclesiastes 1 and verse 9, as I reference that scripture, I'll have to paraphrase. This is Ecclesiasticus chapter 3 and verse 5. And a time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, and a time to embrace, and a time to refrain from embracing. Ecclesiasticus chapter 3 and verse 6, and it reads, and a time to get, and a time to lose, and a time to keep, and a time to cast away. Verse 7, and a time to rend, and a time to sow, and a time to keep silent, and a time to speak. Right, so we are in the time of speaking of increasing prophecies and increasing biblical signs that's about to be fulfilled. And these prophecies that's about to be fulfilled and come to pass as well too. So we see in these increasing of these times, because scripture says my prophet should not be back into a corner no more. So we're risen up to who we actually are, and we're continually being servants and prophets of Heavenly Father, Yahweh, thy power. You know, we're prophesying against great countries and great kingdoms of war, evil, and the pestilence. You know, so hey, we're definitely living in those times, you know. And we are definitely living in a time of speaking these increasing biblical signs and prophecies that's about to be fulfilled and come to pass as well too. This is Ecclesiastica. So I don't want to rock the side that we continue to experience that and be part of that, you know, as we continue to prophesy continually to the best of our ability. You know? Ecclesiastica chapter 3 and verse 8. In a time to love, in a time of H-A-T-E. That's why scripture says, because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. So lawlessness, iniquity is only going to ramp up. You know, divisions between the nations within their nation and outside of their nations. And these wars is only going to increase. Right along with 2 Edges 15 verse 5, behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction as well too. And the WW3 is only going to increase. We've seen increases signs of that, you know. That's why we're prophesying against great countries and great kingdoms of war, evil, and pestilence. So we are definitely living in that times and seasons and every purpose under heaven. You know, especially these increasing biblical signs and prophecies once again soon about to be fulfilled. You know? This is Ecclesiastes chapter 3 and verse 8. In a time of love, in a time of H-A-T-E, in a time of war, right? We're definitely in a time of war, you know, and a time of peace. Because the Heavenly Father, you know, He is a righteous, balanced power. You know, like Isaiah 45 verse 7. I create darkness, I create peace, I create light. I, the Lord, Yahweh, my power does all these things. So this is only going to continue to increase because He's a righteous, balanced power. You know? Get into that second Ezra. As we continue to measure the time diligently in itself, so these wars that we see in between the armies of nations, especially over there in Western Asia, is only going to increase. As we continue to measure the time diligently in itself, as I get into the second Ezra, the ninth chapter. Yep, this is from the Apocrypha book. This is a second Ezra, chapter 9, verse 1, from the Apocrypha books of the Holy Scriptures, and it reads, He answered me then and said, Measure thou the time diligently in itself, what thou seest the parts of the signs past, which I have told you before. Right, so we're going to continue to measure the time diligently in itself, what thou seest the signs past, which I have told you before, you know. It's like He told the prophets before, ancient times, now in modern day times, because there's no new thing under the sun. That's why we continue to measure the time diligently in itself, just like the prophets of old, our great forefathers, they was measuring the time diligently in itself. Now, we're prophets in modern day times measuring the time diligently in itself, and we're taking heed to the words of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, by power, you know, as we continue to discern the times, have the increasing spiritual discernment of what times that we're living in, you know. That's why we continue to lead to the best of our ability, measure the time diligently in itself, you know. And take heed to the words of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, thy power, as us being His servants and prophets, you know. This is a second address, verse 2. It says, Then thou shalt understand, it is a very same time when the highest will begin to visit the world which He made. The highest, which is the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, thy power. So He's ultimately going to visit this earth now. So more than that, which we're seeing right now. So He's only going to increase visit this earth more than ever, because He's the true creator of everything living in existence. So He's the creator of everything. So He's going to visit this earth now. So more than ever, you know. Second Ezra 9 verse 3. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes, uproars, and people in the world. This is like you had a major earthquake over there in North Eastern of Japan. I believe that was a magnitude of a 6.1 earthquake. So we're definitely going to continue to see the high impact earthquakes in diverse places, and the uproars of people in the world, which we're seeing as well too. Second Ezra 9 verse 4, it says, Then thou shalt well understand that the Most High Yahweh thy power spake of these things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. Right, from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. Second Ezra 9 verse 5, For like all that is made in the world, had a beginning and an end is manifest. Right, so the beginning and the end is being manifested. For Esau is the end of the world, Jacob will get up that fellow. Hey, Revelation 11 verse 14, Second will pass, behold, third will come in quick on. I'll bring up that Second Ezra 16 verse 18, then I'm closing up. Now hopefully this lesson was edifying through the spirit of power, grace, and mercy of Yahweh El Shai and the Wadi Yahweh Shem El Shai for letting me have an opportunity chance to do this sit down lesson, put the spirit on me, the Wadi Yahweh Shem El Shai for that. And may Yahweh Shem El Shai continue to put the spirit on all of us, you know, including the elders with Akim, Adawan Ratzah. And once again, Shalom to the elders with Akim with Akwaf. In the Heavenly Father, the true name is Yahweh, and His only begotten Son, Bahashem, in the name of Mashiach Havashah. Those are their true names in the ancient Paleo Hebrew, the Lashwan Kadash, the little tongue, as well too, the Wadi Yahweh Shemel Shah. And this is a second Ezra 16 and verse 18 from the Apocrypha books of the Holy Scriptures, and it reads, The beginning of sorrows and great mournings, the beginning of famine and great death, the beginning of wars, right? Wars. That's the key word, wars. That's why I was bringing up that Joel, the third chapter, and the reference scriptures to back it up as well too, from the Ezekiel 38 chapter through verse 39, Isaiah 17 and verse 1, Jeremiah 51 and verse 46, and Isaiah 17 and verse 1, and Revelation 11 and verse 14, the second will pass, behold, third will come quickly as well too. Second Advent 16 verse 18, it says the beginning of sorrows and great mournings, the beginning of famine and great death, and the beginning of wars, and the power shall stand in fear, and the beginning of evils. What shall I do when these evils shall come? Hey, so with that, hopefully this lesson was edifying through the spirit power, grace and mercy of Yahweh Yahshua, and the Heavenly Father, true name is like Yahweh, and his only begotten Son, Bahashem, in the name of Mashiach Yahshua. Those are their true names in ancient Paleo Hebrew, the last one could ask tongue. And once again, the title of this lesson was Joel, the third chapter. I would say Joel 3, verse 1 through verse 14. And that was the title of the sit-down lesson, right along with the reference scriptures to help me out through the sit-down lesson. And the Wadi Yahweh Hashem Yahshua for giving me an opportunity, chance to bring up the sit-down lesson, putting the spirit on me. The Wadi Yahweh Hashem Yahshua. You know, we say that with meekness, humbleness, and sincerity in the sight of Yahweh Yahshua. And shalom to the elders, wa akim, wa akwaf. Peace and blessings to you and yours, and your friends and family, household as well, too, as we continue to lift up the names of Yahweh Yahshua. And with that, I'd like to give all praises and glory and honor to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, and Bahadash. Shalom to the elders, wa akim, wa akwaf. Until next time, I will say, shalom, and shalom. We work together like